Yes, hello, this is Martha Guptill from CelebrityCharities.com, and I am at the Mid-Atlantic Nostalgia Convention 2016 with the multi-talented actress, film, television, voiceover, producer, and author, Kathy Garver. And so nice to meet this wonderful, talented lady. Kathy, I wanted to welcome you, and I also wanted to ask you if you could give a bit of information about your background to those that don't know, and then to inform others your background and your upcoming projects as well.
Thank you. Well, I'm very happy to be here at the Mid-Atlantic Con as well, and very nice to meet you and your sister and your whole crew and celebrities. I think it's such a wonderful thing. I started out as a very small child. In the Ten Commandments was one of my first movies, and I hate to say, but you know, there's no covering up when you're on film. It's the 60th anniversary of the Ten Commandments this year. I was just a spark, I think, in someone's eye, and so I think it's my spirit that appeared here, because I can't be over 60 minutes.
You might mention gorgeous. That it's not a silent version.
Yes. You're gorgeous.
Well, thank you. And that isn't the silent
version.
Yeah. No. And I segue from there, doing a lot of guest spots on TV, and did more movies. One of the movies I did was The Night of the Hunter, and I did radio, old-time radio. I'm a real big, not only fan, but I was in old-time radio, so I'm an old-timer, but we're doing a lot of recreations, which I love. I go around to different conventions doing that, as well as I have embraced an entire voiceover career and done about 70 audiobooks. And I'm very happy to report that I have won some Audi awards, and I was directing Amy Tan, and one of them was a wonderful author, and we were nominated and then won the award. So I called her and I said, "Amy, isn't this great? We won the Audi." And she said, "Yes, but when you first called, I thought we won a car."
Oh my goodness.
We didn't win cars, but wonderful plaques in crystal, and plus we get to say we won the Audi.
Oh my gracious. Well, honestly. I continue to have such a wonderful career in the voiceover industry and doing commercials, voices for toys, and it's just an incredible career that you have, and with the Family Affair that everyone has known you from. You're also in telling about Family Affair, where it is.
After starring in Family Affair for 5 years, it's also the anniversary of Family Affair for September 12th, 1966. And a friend of mine had some people in Israel that wanted to do a stage musical of Family Affair. And it was all in Hebrew. Well, I don't particularly speak Hebrew, so I learned phonetically all the dialogue and the singing. And I did, I could do that. So I sing that for that stage musical of Family Affair. The life of an actor really has its ups and downs, and it's not the most secure job once you have in the world. So my actual recipe for success, I would say, is to, once I was perhaps not doing a TV series, I would do a stage play, or I would do radio, etc. And I also teach. So I teach a couple workshops every month for speech and diction. I graduated in UCLA with a degree in speech and a master's actually in theater. So I teach speech and diction, and I teach how to create characters for toys and how to create characters for animated series. I got your start in Spider-Man and his amazing friends. And now I have my third book out. So my first book was The Family Affair Cookbook. And then I wrote my memoir, which was Surviving Cissy, after all of that. And my new book, which is out now, called Ex-Child Stars, Where Are They Now? And my literary agent, who is from Maryland, who is with me today, is making two more deals for the sequel to X-Child Stars, which will be X-Child Stars Movies. And then I have a book that I'm writing called Hollywood Letters to a Navy SEAL. So, yeah, and I have a 25-year-old and a husband.
Oh, my.
Yeah. And so that's my whole life.
Now,
I wanted to ask you for any charities or organizations or foundations that are close to your heart, would you speak of those?
Sure. And one of them is A Minor Consideration, which is a nonprofit organization that was put together by Paul Peterson, who was on the Dr. Reed show, because so many of our wonderful young national treasures have been destroyed somewhat by the business, or have not had the abilities to go on and have a successful life as an adult. And unfortunately, many of the earnings that they had worked so hard for had either been taken by their families or unscrupulous business managers. So this organization works with Barbara Brew, who is here with the Washington, D.C. for child labor law. So now a portion of their money is set aside, so when they are 18, they at least have some of the money that they have. Also, Alzheimer's is very close to my heart. Unfortunately, my mother had Alzheimer's, and great inroads are being made in that area, and it just thrills me to see that. But of course, we always need more for the research, but the walks and the different things that are going along with Alzheimer's are really, I think, making great inroads to trying to figure out what is going on in the brain and how we can prevent it, and maybe someday we can find it.
I do want to ask, a website, would you give so others can keep in contact to your upcoming things that are going on?
Yes, my website is KathyGarver.com. With it, KathyGarver.com. And that's a pretty simple one. And people can like me on Facebook, and then I keep a chronicle of what I'm doing. I'm starting a new show called Star Watch, and I have a star on the Walk of Stars in Palm Springs. So next month, this show, I will host and be like you are doing. I will be interviewing celebrities who have a star. Our first one is Lindsay Wagner from Bionic Woman, and then we're doing Gavin McLeod from Love Boat and Mary Tyler Moore. So we're going to do all the stars.
That's a great idea.
That is wonderful. Yeah, absolutely. Well, I wanted to say, thank you so much for being here and speaking today with me about all of your life and projects and your charities. And I thank you so much. It's such a pleasure.
Thank you. Same here.
Thank you.